Everybody breathes out CO2. Can we capture that CO2 and use it for our aquariums? We tried this before, and it unfortunately didn't really work out, but this time, I've made some improvements. This is my DIY CO2 Bell Diffuser 2.0. It features a material upgrade, making it sturdier. With the 1.0 version, applying the device was kind of a pain as the material was very flimsy and soft. Now, with 2.0, the new material enhances its ease of use. Enough with the commercial, let's get on to the experiment. This time, we'll be using an empty tank instead of a bucket. And just like before, we'll be using distilled water to eliminate any variables found in tap water. A piece of foam to see if anything dissolved in the water, and a CO2 drop checker. After setup, a question came into my mind. How can we get the most CO2 out of our breath?
Maybe holding your breath before exhaling would increase the CO2 content of your breath.
Arthur, you're completely right. The longer you hold your breath, the more CO2 builds up in your body. I went and held my breath for as long as I could. This was kind of difficult because I'm an idiot and laughed. After trying a second time, and before I passed out, I exhaled everything right into the diffuser. Before moving on, I tested the pH of the distilled water that I used, and it came out to 6.4. This will be our control sample when it comes to pH testing. I'll check back in an hour and see if anything dissolved into the water. I don't think anything happened. There is barely any difference. Even more, the checker is still blue and the TDS is still the same. Let's wait a few more hours and test again. 3 more hours have passed and it still does not look like there's any change in the diffuser. There is also no change in the checker and the TDS went down by 1. The only difference is that there's bubbles everywhere, but those are probably oxygen bubbles. Our breath does contain about 13.6% to 16% oxygen. I'm not gonna wait any longer, so I went and performed some water testing. KH is at a solid 0 or 1 degree, pH is at 6.4, and ammonia, nitrite, and nitrate are all at 0. When you compare that pH testing to the control group, nothing really changed, and I think I know why. When I initially exhaled into the diffuser, I did not bother to breathe in. I just exhaled immediately. My guess is that initial breath didn't contain as much CO2 as I didn't breathe in and allow my lungs to perform that exchange, if that makes any sense. So I did the entire experiment again, but this time, I inhaled before I exhaled into the diffuser. Hopefully, that would make the diffuser— oh, no, never mind. Nothing happened again. So, as of now, we have no way of utilizing the CO2 in our breath effectively for our planted tanks. The only method I can think of is somehow storing our breath into a high-pressure container. This way, we could control how much CO2 the water will get. All in all, this experiment has been busted. If you have any other Mythbuster ideas, please share them in the comments below. I'd love to tackle them if possible. And if you still have that itch for more aquarium experiments, check out this video where I tested to see if you can use snow water in your aquarium.